I'm V, one from NBC5 Chicago, and this is Senn TV.
Woo!
I'm a convict. I got two truths and one lie. I went to a private island in Florida for spring break. I have a dog who's named after Wrigley Field. And I got straight A's at Senn for all 4 years.
Peace. I am in jail. They're interrogating me.
Player is LeBron James.
I got two brothers named Jeffrey and Andre. And I met Lori Lightfoot.
So my name is Jacob Cool Ranch Sanger. So today we got the myth, the legend, the
man, Colin Conkers, man. I did it, man. I did it all. From LSU bound to me just conquering, getting straight A's at Senn. What else do I have to prove? So one of my friends came up with a challenge that I have to do for you guys.
Colin Conkers!
What if somebody from the shadow was rap label LeBron, but he wasn't talking about coke and birds, it was more like spoken word, except he's really putting it down, and he explained the story.
What's going on, Bulldogs? It's your boy, Davion, Lucas, and behind the camera we got the GOATs, Leslie. I wish she could say what's up, but she's saying it in spirit. We kind of can. Back to you guys. But and around the time of Thanksgiving, me and Mr. C have promised to play 1v1 for you all. But unfortunately, it never happened. And with this being our final episode, we had to put the most anticipated 1v1 in Senn High School history in the video, y'all.
Feels like yesterday when this first got brought up and then teased again. Sorry for the way, y'all. I know y'all want to see this, but now we promise we got y'all. I know for a fact it's going to be one of the best things this Senn had ever had to offer.
Lucas, who you think gonna win?
I just came back from playing basketball. I know Davion my whole life, basically, so I don't know. I got you, Mr. C, though, but I think he gonna have to win it.
Leslie, who you think gonna win? Look, we gonna edit that in. And with that being said, guys, let's get to the 1v1. But wait, Lucas. Like, you know I'm gonna get kind of tired playing this 1v1, right?
32.
So what you think is gonna help?
Yeah, I don't know, Davion. What you got in your pocket?
Hey, this 1v1 is sponsored by Gatorade.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. We are here at the Senn High School Arena to broadcast an exciting matchup tonight.
The matchup is Mr. Colney against Davion Holmes, our all-star football star and our journalistman teacher.
This is going to be an exciting matchup. We're a few minutes away from tip-off, and everyone is getting ready to see some great basketball.
Stay tuned.
Let's get ready to rumble! Our opponent first, Mr. Colin Nane versus your boy, future prom king, Davion Holmes. Matchup of the century. Let's get it on!
And the millions watching around the world.
from the capital city of the United States of America, Washington, D.C., ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
All right, so we're here with Mr. C. How you feeling? It's halftime. How you feeling?
I definitely needed the half. I got more winded than I thought. I thought I'd have some legs against Davion, but definitely winded. Started out strong. I was feeling great. Just couldn't keep it going.
Davion, how you feeling?
Bro, it's too easy. I'm finna clamp up and play defense and get him off the court, man. Like, I'm finna try to make him fall too, so stay tuned.
So wait. So is he better than what you thought he was gonna be?
Nah, anybody can make 3 points, but he all right, I guess.
What's up, Bulldogs? Hey, it's Jan.
And this is Miguel.
We are both exchange students at Senn, and we really enjoyed this year and being in Senn TV and being part of the whole journalism class.
Shout out to the Senn TV crew and to Mr. C for making this possible for us. We wouldn't have gotten the opportunity to do it anywhere else.
Moving on to our episode, the Senn TV crew held a storytelling event on Friday, May 6th.
The goal of the event was for the Senn TV students to share their own stories, since we've spent the entire year covering yours.
Throughout the day, teachers and students attend our amazing stories, and we had pizza and drinks, and it was an awesome time.
Let's check out our amazing stories.
Yay!
Hi, welcome everybody. Today, basically, everybody is going to be telling their stories since we're Senn TV, and we're so used to hearing other people's stories. Now it's y'all turn to hear ours.
On Friday, May 6th, the Senn TV crew held a storytelling event during all lunch periods. Members of the team took turns telling their stories to an audience of teachers and students. Admission was $15, and there was plenty of food and drinks for everyone to enjoy.
Now, I was furious. I wanted to kill this man. He had taken my time, my valuable time that I, as a teenager, could have spent sleeping.
And then after like an hour solving this question with his tutor, I got it right. And when I tell you, I was so happy that I solved it. I was like, yes, God, I got this.
But then they started handing me different flavor popsicles every 5 minutes. And it really lightened the situation. I didn't even notice when they put the numbing cream on.
First vacation, it was a complete disaster.
It, from beginning to end, and if you were to ask my mother, she'd say that it was a disaster before it had even begun.
Out of nowhere, three cop cars surrounded the bus, and a cop got on the bus and was like looking around, looking at everybody.
What you know about?
He's loose!
It was only just a slide on the side, and like you had to slide in, and it would just be like a guy that looked like you hired him from the corner of the street to like catch your kid.
It was like 90 degrees, both the rims were out. I'm like, you know, today might be the day. So I lace up my LeBrons, put on my arm sleeves, put on my headband, and I told myself, you know, today's just gonna be the day I'm gonna do something.
Hi, I'm Emma.
And I'm Aaliyah.
On the eve of Saturday, May 21st, Senn students took a trip to Six Flags Great America.
While they were there, they enjoyed rides, food, and they interviewed people, asking them questions. Speaking of questions, Emma, let's see how much you know about me. We're gonna play two truths and a lie. So, okay, I'll go. I'm wearing contacts. I've been to Florida. I like cats.
I think the lie is you've been to Florida.
Wrong. The lie was that I'm wearing contacts. My turn. I have a twin. I can't swim. And I'm an only child. What is the lie? The lie is you have a twin.
See your episode!
We're very excited. We're gonna whatchamacallit, we'll vlog when we get there, but right now we just I can't even speak. We just got on the bus. There's people coming in, coming out. We're just getting ourselves situated. So yeah, we'll vlog to see how it looks like during the ride. Probably like super dark. That's when we didn't see anything. Like where? There's nothing. Okay, I'm blabbering. All right, I'ma pass the phone back to Afreen after these people pass.
See you in Six Flags, BYT.
We just made it to Six Flags. Say hello to the people.
This is going on
Senn TV, so no cursing, no profanity. Come on, guys.
Look at our tickets. This is Bethany. I am here in front of the Spider-Man, but there is a Batman looking logo thing right there.
It's supposed to be Batman and not Spider-Man.
What Jackie said. But I'm waiting for Afreen, Layla, Miguel, Leslie.
Very good gourmet.
Say hi, guys.
You have a portable room.
Say hi, Senn TV.
Checking it, bro. We just got off the Raging Bull.
It was crazy.
Oh my God.
That was.
Oh my God, bro. Out of body experience.
Oh my God. Out of body.
Bro, we just got told that 25 more kids have to board this bus.
Okay.
Bro. I like it. 25. You're just gonna be crazy. Love that.
Cuddle up, baby. Cuddle up.
I'm cuddled up with you.
This shit's crazy.
But then once I need to fall asleep, I'm gonna be like, no.
It's gonna be great.
Just, how are y'all feeling about the fact that we have to get more people on this bus? Terrible.
Would you like, can we get you a candid reaction? It's terrible. And how do you feel about the situation, love?
I wanna go.
Hey guys, it's Edwin Neary.
I'm Jalen Rogers.
What up, y'all? It's S here.
And we got the opportunity to go downtown to Loyola's campus to explore their journalism program and their studio.
We got the opportunity to mentor sophomores and juniors that were also from the Senn TV program. And we also got the opportunity to do personal on the street downtown on Michigan Avenue.
Let's check it out.
We couldn't seem to shake the chilly, dreary weather with only 2 days of significant sunshine in the past 45 days. But warm weather finally seems to return to Chicago this week, and Senn TV students hit the streets to ask people about their plans to enjoy it now and over the summer. Let's see what they had to say.
Out in the city, it's a good day outside. So what did you eat for breakfast? What did you have for breakfast?
I had granola with peanut butter and oat milk.
People go to school for 8 years, they end up in McDonald's.
Exactly.
Or it's not right.
Oh, breakfast. I didn't actually have breakfast, so I'm staying in a hotel. I just had a packet of biscuits that was I already had.
We've just been up the Chicago 360.
Oh.
Up the top. Good, nice views of the whole of Chicago.
Plan on doing in the summer.
What are you training?
Now that it's getting warmer, the temperature, what do you plan on doing in the summer? What are your plans?
Sorry, no, my English is not good.
Okay. Thank you anyway.
Do you have any plans for the summer?
Actually, I'm going to remodel my kitchen, so yeah.
Ooh, okay, what type of look are you going for? Are you trying to do modern or what?
Yeah, just update my kitchen.
What are we doing? Hi guys.
This is our last episode.
Anyways, today we're going to do
two truths and a lie.
Yeah. So who wants to go first?
You can go first.
I guess I'll go first. Eh? Okay. All right. Okay. Two truths, one lie. Okay. She's laughing at me, guys.
No,
tell her to stop. Like she already knows.
No, I don't.
Shut up. Okay. Anyways. All right. Okay. First one is, I taught myself how to tie my own shoelaces. The second one is, I went to Vietnam only one time in my life. Bro! Okay. And then the last one is, I am a winter baby. Now, figure out which one is the two truths, which one is the lie. I'll give you guys 10 seconds. Hold on. I'm going to put a timer right now, guys.
Wait, can we do teamwork?
Teamwork? You guys want to do teamwork?
Yeah, like, do we do teamwork? Or, like, is it just, like...
No, it's y'all separate.
Okay.
Separately, okay? Hold on.
Hold on. Yeah, show me the options again. Yeah, I think you teaching yourself to tie your own shoelaces.
That's a lie?
Yeah.
What do you think?
I would say I'm a winter baby is a lie.
All right. The two truths is that I went to Vietnam only one time in my life, and I am a winter baby. My birthday's in January, where literally winter peaks. And the lie is I taught myself how to tie my own shoelaces. Unfortunately, I couldn't girl boss it when I was like that young, so I had my dad teach me. Yeah.
Did you see that? Of course, I won.
I'll go next. This is so easy.
Okay.
So mine is, I can speak four languages. I love dogs. And I like green tea more than coffee.
Okay. All right. You want to say it first?
Well, I had a different guess.
Oh really? Yeah, me too. Me too.
I mean, you like dogs, but I wouldn't say you love them. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to assume that that's the way.
I think it's the same thing that Leslie said. Afreen, she is terrified of multiple types of animals and reptiles and amphibians, literally anything that has four legs or two legs only, including humans. So I say the lie was her loving dogs.
Right? Yeah.
Okay. You guys are correct.
Go, Leslie. All right, so my two truths and a lie. I rode my first roller coaster when I was 3 years old. What was my other one? Oh, me tweaking. I got my first pair of glasses in fifth grade. And my other one, what was it? Oh, my first pet's name was Muñeca.
Wait.
Oh my gosh. I would say that her first pet name was Muñeca. It's a lie.
I think the lie is that she went on her first roller coaster when she was 3.
Okay, so I did get my first pair of glasses love that. Okay. So much love. I did get my first pair of glasses when I was in third grade, so good job. Y'all didn't guess that one. And the lie was that my first pet's name, that my pet's name. First off, I had a, that was my mom's pet's name, but yeah. So I did go on a roller coaster when I was 3 years old.
I had a feeling that you did too, though. I just don't remember you talking about your pet at all.
Yeah.
Damn.
Rematch. Hey, but you'll know who's the best friend because I got all of them right. Damn, they fake. They fake, bro. They fake. Wow. It's okay.
I was about to say see you guys.
Actually, we aren't going to see you guys, but it's okay.
We can't be like, excuse me, good to see you guys next episode anymore. Oh, well.
Bye-bye.
Right. See you guys until whenever we see you.
Hey guys, back at it again. It's Bethany,
Leslie,
and Efrain.
And I don't know if you guys watched our previous episodes on Senn TV, but we did a weird food combo thingamajiggy. I wasn't there. But it was a blast, right?
Yes.
It was definitely interesting.
Funny, very funny. Had some amazing reactions.
The food wasn't good though.
I think they had like pickles or something. Y'all have pickles or something, right? And
never again.
Comment if you guys like pickles. If you're a pickle queen.
I actually love pickles.
Oh, like that. Love pickles. Anyways. So today we're gonna do something very similar to that, and we're gonna do a like a cultural snack food thingy. So that's where like every Senn TV member, they're gonna bring in something that they've always been eating all their lives, like their comfort food or maybe your little snackies or whatever. And then in a way, we're just spreading our culture, learning about others, right?
Yes, ma'am. And okay, I guess that's it for it from us. So let's check out the video.
So these are salted fried lentils.
3, 2, 1.
Chew them. How? Oh my god, get out of here, Damien.
Dude, we just put them in your mouth like right now.
I don't know what they taste like. What does it taste like?
Nothing.
Imagine, like, oh yeah.
Stop.
It's not bad. It tastes like a peanut.
3, 2, 1.
The silence is so loud.
Where?
I'm not gonna lie to you, this tastes like goldfish.
3, 2, 1.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's quite crunchy.
You're the first person to like it, guys.
I told you they'd like it.
Oh, never mind.
Actually, it is good.
Yeah. Thank you.
I told you they'd like it.
A little dry and then I'm like, but yeah, I'm good.
Personally, for me, I'll give it like a 5 because.
Okay. That's pretty high.
Stop.
Earned it.
Whatever.
Rate it.
A 3.
Let me try
these. You just spit it out and rated it 3.
Right, like.
I don't want to be me.
5 out of 10. I'd say it's like a 6 out of 10. I mean, it's a bit salty, but it's decent for what it is. I mean, it's just goldfish. If you like goldfish, you'll like it, but like, there's like nothing much to it.
Well, how would you rate it out of 10?
I would say 7.
Okay, Miguel?
6.5.
6.5 and 7. Good. That's pretty high.
And then I brought in candy because it was the first thing that came to mind.
I like it. Not bad. I like it. I think it's good.
No, I got a good taste of it. Like.
3, 2, 1.
That was barely even hot, I'm not gonna lie to you.
It's not really hot.
Like, that was nothing.
No.
No, but like, that was like a strawberry that like,
It had like a different kind of flavor to it.
It's a gummy.
Hey. Yeah. It's actually really good. It was really good.
How would you rate it?
Yeah. Did you have more? You have more? Yeah.
For me, I'll give this like a 8 out of 10. Not even 8 out of 10. I'll give it a 7.5 out of 10.
Wait, like, what did you rate the gummies?
3.
My has way more chili than yours.
Out of 10, I'd probably give like an 8. Well, that was a solid 8, honestly. I really enjoyed that, actually. Look, I'm sorry. You can't go... Look, this is goldfish crackers, and that's just candy. I'm sorry, but...
No, the first one was not no goldfish crackers. I give this a 9 out of 10. It was really good. I'm not gonna lie.
Okay,
I'll
take it. It's a solid 8.5.
8.5? And then
yeah.
You go?
I think an 8.
8?
They're mango lollipops, and they're covered in chili, as you can see.
Mm-hmm. Chili?
So cute. Mm-hmm. Oh, they're so bomb. Personally, my favorite part is the outside, and then I don't really like the mango lollipop.
Why not? I like the mango better than the outside. I'm not gonna lie, I've had these like a bunch of times.
I've never had it before. It's covered in chili.
But yeah, I don't know how you gonna react to it, but I like them. It's gonna take you a minute to eat it.
I feel like your initial taste of this, like, you're not gonna like it, but the more like you like, I don't want to say like. The more you
suck it.
Yeah, buddy, yeah.
The more you suck it, you know, it tastes better.
3, 2, 1. Oh my God.
Oh my God, bro. I mean, it's fruity when you get to like the aftertaste, but like the beginning, it's like a whole bunch of like heat and show. It's like, it's weird. I can get why people like it, but it's definitely acquired taste.
Probably. I get these like an 8.5 out of 10.
Rate it. Rate it.
It's a 5.
Okay, so ratings, what were your ratings?
I'd say like a 7 out of 10.
How would you rate it?
A 1 out of 10.
The leaves, they like extract the stuff from the leaves and then they make it into like whatever the hell that is. And then this is gonna be like so that's typical custard and pandan. And the dough.
Okay.
And this is the mung bean, which is similar to a custard, but it's made out of mung beans. It's not that bad. And then with durian. 3, 2, 1.
You're supposed to throw it all in your mouth.
I don't even know what it tastes like myself. But I know it's good. I like pandan.
It's decent. I like it.
You like it?
Good, yeah.
Yeah. No, what is this?
No, aftertaste just saved it.
3, 2, 1, go. To be honest, it's not as bad as you think it is. It could be worse. Because it's in the dessert, so they make it sweeter. And the smell isn't as, like, it's pretty artificial. Not yawn! It can't break yawn.
Well, I think I just broke him. It's all right.
It's all right? That's fine.
That's an easy 8.
Yeah.
That's an easy 8. I
surprise
like
guess for tasting. What you think? Bro, from the jug?
It's good. 10 out of 10, bro.
Damn, okay.
I grew up eating this. I like. How would you rate it?
Like a 5.
5?
I'm not going to lie to you. This tastes like egg rolls.
Egg rolls?
I don't think I have it.
Like, this tastes like egg rolls. It was like a dessert, like a bakery treat.
Yeah.
This seems...
I wouldn't have it.
Like, yeah, I wouldn't have it either, again. Honestly.
No, like, I wouldn't just, like, buy it and eat it.
I might just eat some jail food.
Right. I like
whenever
it.
Whenever you're given to it, you try it out.
I eat it. Well,
not bad, Okay.
I'm just not really used to the taste. I'm not the biggest fan of it.
I'm really disappointed.
How would you rate it, Young?
Like a 3.
3 out of 10?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go what he said.
Yeah. I love
it. I'm giving it a 4 out of 10.
The advertisement makes it look so special.
Okay, you gotta.
How do we just
open it? Yeah.
What? Say look. Y'all feeding us.
Yeah, but you gotta be careful. It's like very juicy.
It is.
Like it's.
That's what the napkins are for.
How y'all just open this?
Whoa.
I feel left out.
I think I got honeydew. It tastes like the real.
Hey, I got left out.
What?
Oh yeah, it's hard. Why are you opening it like that? Open it the other way.
What do you want me to do? Like this? Like the thing?
No, like this.
Bro, just open it with your mouth, my guy.
Yeah.
Or like do that and twist it with your mouth or something.
Bro, give me this.
We should have got scissors.
Oh, bro.
I know, this
one's
fine.
We should have. Damn, that's juicy.
Damn. Bad juicy.
You got coconut?
Yeah. And I'm not gonna get that.
I only tasted the juice, but this is really good.
This is good? You like it?
It has a good taste. I can tell this has a good taste to it. Cause I kind of got it to open.
It tastes like honeydew for you. Honeydew is really good.
I don't even like it. We did that with scissors.
Thank you.
Really?
Yes,
nice.
Oh, look, Mr. C's here to save the day.
He made my life hard.
Oh, Mr. Colin, here.
2 minutes.
No. What? I got a little hole.
Wait. Did you not hear any rings?
I said 9.
8.5.
Look at that. He didn't even try anything yet.
If it was colder and more liquidy, this
would if it was colder, if it was cool, it would be like a 9.5, 10.
This is like a solid.
But it was like room temperature.
8.7.
It was it was alright. It was good.
It was good though.
If it's frozen, it'd probably be a
good thing. If this was in a fridge or something, bro.
What's your ratings?
I'll give this an 8.
Yeah. 8.5.
Okay, Colin?
I'll give it an 8.
Jacob?
7 out of 10.
Okay.
I would say I only put like a few points off because of the...
Well, like I just said, this feels a lot like Go-Gurt, to be honest.
I actually don't mind it being hard to open because then you enjoy it more.
Reporting live for the last time, it's your boy, Davion Holmes.
Lucas Paulos. Davion, we got some pretty big news going on today. Why don't you fill me on what's happening?
So, while I was downtown, I was able to run into NBC 5's own V-Win. She was able to come to our class today to answer a couple questions and talk to us about her experience as a journalist. And I was able to get a one-on-one interview with Ms. Win just to pick her brain and ask her a couple questions. Let's see what she had to say.
This business is that you need to have compassion, you need to have empathy. You know, you need to be able to understand or try to understand what people are going through.
On May 23rd, NBC5's own V1 stopped by our studio. We were so grateful to have her in the studio just talking about her job and what she does best. Luckily, your boy was able to get an interview with her. So let's see what Ms. Win had to say.
What's going on, Bulldogs? It's your boy, Davion Holmes, and I promised y'all that I was going to bring a special guest to the episode. Today, we have V-Win of NBC5.
Hi, Bulldogs. It's V-Win with NBC5. I'm so glad to be here.
Yeah, we are really excited to have you here. Like, really, really excited. And along with this program, we start our sophomore year with broadcast journalism, and we kind of grow together as a team. Can you just tell us about your team at NBC5 and like the hard work that y'all put and how y'all collab together just to produce the episodes?
Yeah. I've never been on the other side of the microphone or the other side of the camera. But yeah, I mean, like, everybody at NBC5 is so great. We all work together every single day and we work as a team and we communicate with each other. So I feel like communication is the key to success. So communication is very important. And we just all get along. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So getting along produces great episodes.
Yes.
See, guys, it all worked out for us. All right, second question. I was born on the south side of Chicago, so I know the violence there is completely, like, you see something new every day. Like, what's the toughest story that you had to cover on the south side of Chicago, and like, what advice would you give for a journalist who has to cover those stories? Like, what emotion do you want to put into those stories just so they can be more relatable to everybody, so they can understand the struggle that are happening on the inner cities of Chicago?
Mm-hmm. There's been so many different stories in the city, but I'll just say, you know, speaking in terms of just the city, shootings, I mean, young kids, young babies, victims, you know, being caught in the crossfire. And I think that's really, that's so sad and very traumatizing.
So when I was introducing myself to you, I know that I told you that I want to major in sports journalism. So I did my research and I came to find out that you like the Green Bay Packers. What made you a Packers fan and why? Why are you a Packers? See, like, I'm not a Bears fan. My favorite team is the defending Super Bowl champions, the Los Angeles Rams. So, like, what made you like the Packers when you covered Chicago news?
Yeah.
That's okay. First off, good like reporting and journalist skills, you know, doing your research on the people that you're about to interview. But yeah, I mean, I just love the Green Bay Packers and Aaron Rodgers. And yeah, for some reason, I mean, like even when I was in college and high school, I've never been a fan of the Bears.
You know, we needed this. This is the moment that we've been waiting for. Can you just say, this is V-Win and you're watching Senn TV.
Okay. This is V-Win and you're watching Senn TV.
Y'all heard it, folks. Back to our anchors.
Well, unfortunately, our episode is coming to an end.
But we really enjoyed being back at school and in this program.
And, I mean, all the time we've spent together will not be taken for granted.
And since we spent so much time together,
I think that we should test out how well we know each other.
I have 13 siblings. I'm adopted, and I've gotten stuck in an elevator.
Oh, wow, okay. 13 siblings, that's a lot of kids. That's a lot of child support. So I'm gonna, and I know the second fact. So I think the first one's a lie.
You're wrong.
I'm wrong? You have 13 siblings? I have 5 pets. I was in a movie once, and I have a half sibling.
I don't think you have 5 pets.
You're wrong, actually. I do. So suck on that. Yeah. Look at me, covered in cat hair right now, and you're gonna tell me that I don't have 5 pets, man. Oh, I got 5.
I got cat fur on me too. Fucking.
You know what? We're just gonna play. We're gonna play the rest of the episode now.
What was it? Okay, it was the. What was it? Hold on. What were the 3 options? I forgot.
Oh, 5 pets.
I know what it was.
I didn't want to assume that you weren't in a movie.
All right.
Were you in a movie?
Yeah, I was in a movie actually once. Yeah, as a baby.
So you don't have a half sibling?
I don't have a half sibling.
I thought you did.
No.
Oh.
I'm an only child.
Oh, yeah.
Action. I love you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi guys.
Hi.
I hope you guys enjoyed this season of Senn TV. We're all going our different ways after this year.
We're going back to our home countries, Germany and Portugal, and they're going off to college.
Yeah!
Alright, let's one more time in 3, 2, 1.
I'm V1 from N.
We don't know that.
Really? I'm almost in everything. We're starting right now.
Right. Oh! Oh my god.
Oh my damn!
Hola muchachos y muchachas.
No, no, I don't even know what this is.
No,
I do.